last year we weren't able to have this in person. We pushed it, the seniors did do something virtually, but the underclassmen we did in the fall, so I got to see that a little bit in the beginning of the year. Thank you for being socially distant, as we always have to be here. Dean Riley did a great job taking these things off and continues to upgrade it every time somebody moves it. So tonight we're honoring you and your work. And what's kind of fun, I think, about this is that most of you know you won an award, but you don't know what you won it in, which is kind of exciting. One of the things, I've been here now for, it feels longer than a year, but just a little under a school year. I've been so impressed with the students at East Catholic. They work hard, they take their studies seriously, and I think that's not everybody, but a good strong majority. But you are the top of the top, and you should feel very proud of being here and being recognized by your teachers for your great accomplishments. And I hope that you do take pride in that, and that you're an important part of East Catholic High School. Obviously, it's a school first and foremost. We do lots of extracurriculars and arts and athletics and clubs, but the work done in the classroom is crucial, and I know it's not easy. So congratulations to you all in advance. We look forward to recognizing you tonight. At this time, I'd like to invite Father Jaime up to give us a opening prayer.
If you are able, I would invite you to stand up. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, we read the book of Hebrews. But just as you excel in everything, in faith, in speech, in knowledge, in complete earnestness, and in the love we inspire in you, see that you also excel in this grace of giving. Heavenly God, we give you thanks for the gift of life, for the gift of lives of all the students that we have here today that we honor. We give the life for their parents and their caregivers, friends. We ask you to continue inspiring them, that they be able to use their knowledge, their talents, and give to others. May they be inspired to excel in giving. Send us your blessing. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Okay, here we go. We're going to begin tonight with the presentation of the Archbishop Henry J. O'Brien Scholars. The Archbishop Henry J. O'Brien Scholars are unique to East Catholic High School. Father Charles E. Shaw, East Catholic's first principal, instituted the O'Brien Scholars, thus beginning the tradition of honoring a group of top graduates rather than only one or two. The O'Brien Scholars represent the highest in academic achievement and exemplify outstanding qualities of leadership and integrity. Father Shaw chose the name to honor the Hartford Archbishop who established East Catholic High School in 1961. We're going to read off the honorees one by one. Please give some applause as they come up onto the stage between them. And then we'll ask you all to stay right over here as a group, stay masked, and then we'll get a group picture with all of the O'Brien Scholars. Christian Bergeron. Ethan Cannon. Ellie DeSantos. Alexandra Gooden. Long. Vaughn, who's in absentia. Claire Murphy. Samuel Nevis. John Paul Boy. And Ethan Peck.
This year's recipient is Jonathan Green. This year's recipient is Ella Lamont. Eleanor is also the recipient of the Academic Award for Advanced Placement U.S. History and Honors French 3. Yeah. This year's recipient is Ashley Zhang. Ashley is also the recipient of the Academic Award for Piano Fundamentals and Honors Spanish 3. High school juniors who demonstrate strong leadership qualities, positively impact their school and local community, and have a proven academic record. This year's recipients are Michael Riley Jr. and Lindsay O'Neill. Lindsay is also the recipient of the Academic Award for Honors English 3. Demonstrate outstanding school and community leadership. This year's recipient is Jason Wellings, Jr. This year's recipient is James Capodanno. Or work in a specific community. This year's recipient is Catherine Green. Catherine is also the recipient of the Academic Award for Advanced Placement English, Language, and Composition. Embody stellar performance in the classroom, but also serve and want to make a difference in the community. They are individuals who lead by example, understand the importance of academic endeavors, and have a commitment for improving today's community. This year's recipients are Allison Parent, please hold your applause till the end, Allison Parent, Mallory Krzyzewski, Matthew Cesaro, Annabelle Stabach, and Grace Falsman. Strength of character necessary to employ the results of their scholarship for the betterment of society. This year's recipient is Paige Sierra. So Excel Book Award is presented to a junior who is an active participant in extracurricular activities. This year's recipient is Olivia Lonsky. Demonstrated an interest and ability in computing. This year's recipients are Kevin Leger and Evan Masella. Emmett is also the recipient of the Academic Award for Physics. Citizen in their school and or community and demonstrates outstanding achievement in innovation, creativity, or entrepreneurship. This year's recipient is Marco Camus. Marco is also the recipient of the Academic Award for Honors Music Theory 1 and Honors Christian Ethics. Those students who have not only excelled in the classroom, but have been role models and community leaders. This year's recipients are Megan Croyle and Anna Pastor. who exemplifies academic achievement, leadership qualities, and concern for others. This year's recipient is Catherine Schaff. Catherine is also the recipient of the Academic Award for Advanced Placement Chemistry. Exemplifies a commitment to their education and school community. This year's recipient is Catherine Merrick. The Trinity College Book Award honors an exceptional junior. This year's recipient is Benjamin Carson. Community and of responsibility that prepares him or her for subsequent leadership in building a society that is at once more human and more divine. This year's recipient is Elizabeth Orchin Baker. The University of Rochester Bashamom Honorary Science Award is presented to a junior who demonstrates high achievement and rigor in science and math classes and has positive contributions to their school and within the larger community. This year's recipient is Kiara Troy. Awarded to a junior who has demonstrated commitment to understanding and addressing difficult social issues, has shown leadership and dedication to community action, and has rigorous courses taken in the humanities and social sciences. This year's recipient is Taylor Pickering. The University of Rochester George Eastman Young Leaders Award is presented to a junior who shows strong leadership experience at school and in the community, has challenging courses, and has extensive involvement in extracurricular activities. The issue's recipient is Emma Duto. Emma is also the recipient of the Academic Award for Honors U.S. History. University of Rochester Xerox for Innovation and Information Technology Award is presented to a junior with a strong interest in innovation and/or information technology and demonstrates a high level of achievement. This year's recipient is Nathan Posner. Is presented to a junior who has demonstrated both outstanding dedication to scholarship inside the classroom and impressive duty to citizenship outside the classroom. This year's recipient is Emma Bonjorowski. Emma is also the recipient of the Academic Award for U.S. History. Recognizes a female honor student with an exceptional academic record and character who has made significant personal contributions to her school. This year's recipient is Heidi Lee. Heidi is also the recipient of the Academic Award for Strings and UConn Advanced Placement Calculus BC. Honors a student who embodies the spirit and integrity of and has the intellect of a leader. This year's recipient is Adriana Ordea. Exhibits the following: exceptional academic achievement in a rigorous college prep program with a focus on coursework in science, technology, engineering, or mathematics, commitment to leadership and is an engaged member of her student community, and strong ability to collaborate, innovate, and problem solve. This year's recipient is Kasha Nolan. Kasha is also the recipient of the Academic Award for Honors French 4. Xavier University honors a junior who is academically talented, acts as a leader in the school community, and is an illustrious student who practices higher thinking and aspires for greatness. This year's recipient is Talia Crowley. University Book Award is presented to a member of a junior class who combines excellence in scholarship with exemplary citizenship. This year's recipient is Konstantinos Soteriou. Konstantinos is also the recipient of the Academic Award for Honors Latin 3-4 and UConn Physics General Physics 1. Present the next scholarship awards.
Thank you, Ms. Brillo. Congratulations to all those book award recipients. Give them another hand. This group of AP scholars will ask to come up and stand together up here for a group picture. The AP scholars are granted to students who receive scores of 3 or higher on 3 or more AP exams. This year's honorees are Elizabeth Adams, Matthew Emerson, May Veran Portland, Claire Murphy, Alexandra Parsons, and Jake Pham. Percentile in their junior year PSAT, and this year's commended student is Jake Pham. The AP scholars with honors are granted to students who receive an average score of at least 3.25 on all AP exams taken and scores of 3 or higher on 4 or more of these exams. This year's honoree is John Paul Hoy. Each year, the Office of Education, Evangelization, and Catechesis honors seniors who represent the top 5% of the graduating class in terms of academic performance. This year's honorees are Alexandra Gooden, May Veran Portolans, Wong Hua, Claire Murphy, and Sam Nevis, who just got back from his game, it looks like, and John Paul Hoy.
I
We won. That's it. This time I will turn things over to, we'll start with our departmental awards, and to kick it off, Mrs. Lisa Kirsch for the English department.
Thank you very much. On behalf of the English department, the English teachers would really like to thank everybody who's here tonight. Just excellent job. And a shout out to the two ladies who've already collected their certificates tonight in the English department. Congratulations, Lindsay O'Neill and Katie Green. I have certificates for others. First, in English 1, the English department would like to recognize two students, George Koulisis and Carl Nolan. Also in ninth grade, we would like to recognize, in literary arts, Adam Eskin. In English 2, we recognize Sydney Ledoux. And also in English 2, Colin Turr. To recognize in Honors American Literature, sophomore Caitlin Nyler. Next, in English 3, onto our juniors. In English 3, we'd like to recognize Rachel Donnelly. And also in English 3, we're happy to recognize Olivia Gerber. Noted our honorees in Honors Junior English and in AP English Language. That brings us to our seniors already. So in Senior English, we are delighted to recognize Katie Batman. And we're also pleased to recognize Jalen Harrigan. Senior English, we're very happy to recognize Christian Bergeron. And in advanced placement, English literature and composition, we're delighted to recognize Maeve Horan Porterman. and move to the four-year award in the English department, let me point out that this senior class has blessed our teachers with not one, but many competent, talented scholars, and it's been our pleasure teaching all of you. What a wonderful challenge for us to choose our four-year award winner from the class of 2021. Because of her affinity for language and her drive to use her own words with clarity, thoughtfulness, and purpose. Because of her deep intellectual curiosity and her dedication to both the challenges and the joys of new learning. Because of her unfailing work ethic and her unwavering sense of integrity. And because of the way she's flourished every year in tangible ways as a critical thinker, a literary analyst, and a writer, we are delighted to honor Elizabeth Adams as our four-year award winner. Thank you so much. It's my pleasure to now introduce the head of the Fine Arts Department, Mr. David Phillips.
Fine Arts Department is full of amazing, talented, hardworking students, and it's difficult every year to come up with award winners, just pick one student. We've done the best we can, but we'd like to thank every student in the department for all of their hard work. This year, for graphic design, the award winner is Morgan Fry. Video, Kevin Hartnett. For Honors Advanced Projects Digital Arts, Julius Nunes. Principles of Design, Guadalupe Rivas. For Drawing, John Riviera. For Sculpture, Richard Simic. For Painting, Brianna Bach. Projects at Studio Arts, Aiden Parizo. For Advanced Placement Studio Arts, Colin Williams. For intermediate piano, Maximus Atella. For chamber choir, Elise Fritsch. For honors East Catholic Choral Ensemble, Morgan Chambers. Finally, one that's here. For concert band, Alexandra Parsons. Advanced Placement Music Theory, Abigail Kaiser. The Visual Arts 4-year award. Every student at East Catholic is required to take a minimum of 1 year of art, but some choose to continue their studies a bit further to express their personal feelings, enhance their shared sense of identity, express spiritual beliefs, and or explore the functionality of art. Even fewer still are involved in the Visual Arts department for all 4 years. To do so represents a dedication and commitment to their passion that involves not only foregoing study halls, but other electives as well. This year, the 4-year Visual Arts Award is going to a talented student who has made art an important part of her life all 4 years at East. This year's recipient is a wonderful influence on every class she participates in, from introductory classes to AP. An eager learner, she challenges herself to explore every genre of art. She has also involved herself in extracurricular activities, including the art club, of which she is president and has been an integral part of every project they have accomplished this year. Photography is her medium of choice, and she excels at creating beautiful and complex themes and images. She plans to pursue this art form in her collegiate studies. A kind, thoughtful, and insightful person, we know she will succeed in anything she puts her mind to. It's a great pleasure for me to bestow the 4-year Visual Art Award to Angela Gerard. Four-year Music Department Award is given annually to a student who has shown consistent dedication and service to the Music Department during all 4 years there at East Catholic. A student who has worked to better him or herself and participate whenever possible to enhance the department. The Music Department is full of dedicated students who give their time and talents freely and who show great dedication to the department and to their art. This makes choosing a student to receive this award a difficult annual task. This year's recipient has been a consistent presence in the music department for the last 4 years. He has always stepped up when asked, happy to help or take on an extra performance responsibility, and has done so with great poise. His willingness to perform additional music whenever called upon, whether that's for a small group or the entire student body, has been a tremendous asset. He's a member of TRIAM, the National Music Honor Society, and his peers elected him as an officer. He's also been an elected officer on numerous occasions for the jazz band. Though he had arrived at East as a talented, hardworking, and caring individual, we've had the pleasure of watching him grow both as a musician and a person during the last 4 years, and he's become an effective leader. He cares deeply about music and the music department as a whole, and is someone who I could always point to as someone for younger students to emulate. It's my great honor to present this year's 4-year Music Department Award to John Paul Hoy. Math Department and Ms. Gina Burby.
Angelique Trump. four-year math award, the department came together and really thought about the special student. This four-year math award winner has shown not only dedication to high achievement, but a true love for mathematics. Her intellectual curiosity is shown in her thoughtful questions and her genuine enjoyment of watching mathematical concepts come together. She works not only to succeed for herself, but to help others in class understand the material as well. Her presence is a joy in any classroom, and she will be strongly missed next year. This year's four-year mathematics award winner is Maeve Moran Portland.
Church and Sacraments, and Juan Gomez. And for Church and Sacraments, Angeline Nunez. there were a lot of choices from this year's senior class. One stood out, and the reflections I'm going to share with you are actually from, I'm going to put Mr. Vansky on the spot, right from Mr. Vansky. I did not have the pleasure of teaching this student, but I'll try to speak on his behalf. So when reflecting about this student, the Bible passage that came to mind is Micah 6:8. And what does the Lord require of you? To act justly, to love goodness, and to walk humbly with your God. This person lives out his faith both inside and outside the classroom. He has many gifts and talents, which he has generously shared with our community. I'm probably going to give away his identity now, but he is a piano player and shares his beautiful piano playing at our school masses. He is beyond talented in Irish step dancing, singer and dancer for our school musicals, runner in cross country and track. He's a devoted member of his parish in Glastonbury. He loves his family. And in the classroom, he actively participates in class discussions and is an inquisitive, deep thinker. He knows and lives out his faith and exemplifies the goodness of our good God. And when Mr. Bansky asked the class who was the most honest, sincere, and genuine student in the class, they all said, John Holloway.
On behalf of the Science Department would like to congratulate everyone who's won awards tonight. But here are our awards. For Honors Physics, Christian Bergeron. For Human Anatomy and Physiology, Gino Brooks.
For chemistry, Maximus Italian.
Talia. For Honors Forensic Science, Max Limerick. For Biology, Sweden Haverson. For Honors Bench Group, Megan Rakoff. And for chemistry, Guadalupe Rivas. Now, for this next, well, I'll say awards, because I'm going to say this person, I'm not going to care twice. I have not had the pleasure of teaching the student, but I have to say, your teachers speak so highly of you. So these two awards are going to go for Advanced Placement Biology and our 4-year science award. Throughout your 4 years here at East Catholic, you have received awards in Honors Chemistry, AP Chemistry, and now AP Biology. Your teachers have known your competence, your respectful nature, and your determination to succeed. This award is given proudly as a witness to your hard work, dedication, and endless curiosity. We in the Science Department celebrate your achievements here at East and wish you the very best as you continue with your science education. May you meet all your future goals and achieve the dreams that are ahead of you in the future. Congratulations on your achievement, Maeve Perrine Portman. At this time, I would like to call up Mrs. Anne Marie Ward from the Social Studies Department.
Back there.
As Winston Churchill said in World War II, keep calm and carry on. As FDR said during the Depression, you have nothing to fear but fear itself. You are the stalwarts. You have persevered amid trying times. You have overcome overwhelming odds, a pandemic, remote learning, which technically I think is worse than the pandemic, quarantines, suspended sports seasons, separation from friends and family, missed holidays, and yet here you are. You're being acknowledged and honored for your academic success during the times that truly wear everybody down, and you are the stalwarts. Recognized for excellence in the social studies are the following East Catholic students. World Civilizations, Luke Veltri. Outstanding work in World Civilizations, Aiden Sargent. Outstanding work in Honors World Civilizations, Faith Moran. outstanding work in modern civilizations, Natasha Otega. Outstanding work in modern world civilizations, Anthony DiMartino. Are you Darren's son?
Yeah.
Well, the legend continues. Congratulations. Honest World Civilizations, Caitlin Nyberg. Outstanding work in civics, Kendra Obrecki. Outstanding work in civics, Sidley Ledoux. Work in honors civics, Catherine Santini. Outstanding work in U.S. history, Olivia Gerber. Outstanding work in honors economics, John Paul Oy. Outstanding work in the deadliest century, Ethan Udemar. Outstanding work in current events and geography, Alexander Mortimer. Outstanding work in social psychology, Alexandra Gooden. Outstanding work in advanced placement Euro history, modern Western traditions, Matthew Emerson. The 4-year Social Studies Award goes to a young lady whose quiet dignity belies a mover and a shaker, a thinker, community involvement, hard worker, a lover and respect for her fellow human beings. Her activity in the community is always on a positive note. It was a pleasure to have this child in class last year. Christine Dua, you are the recipient of the Social Studies. Ryan's Deli.
It's a good thing.
Give a hand for Ms.
Good evening. It's great to be with you all. It's my honor to present the awards on behalf of the World Language Department. We will begin with French. Our recipient for French Award for French 1 is Isabelle Tacouan. Our recipient for Honors French 1 is Adam Eskin. Our recipient for the Honors French 2 Award is Robert Perry. French 3 and French 4 have already received their awards, so our next recipient is for AP French Language and Culture, and then our recipient is May for AP for Language. For Latin 2 is Zoe Latina. Our recipient for Honors Latin 2 is Jacob Taylor. Thank you. for is Evan Redu. We now proceed to Spanish. For our Spanish 1 awards, we have George Cuisis and Shay Boyle. For Honor Spanish 1 is Cecilia Johnson. Spanish 2 are Rishi Malakali and Colin Turner. Our recipient for Honor Spanish 2 is Tiffany Nguyen. Our next award is for Honor Spanish 4, and that's for Lizzie. The words of Madame. So much energy, enthusiasm, and talent in this young person. In fact, for some reason, all of the qualities we can associate with her reach a high level of intensity as if she was naturally blessed with all of these attributes. She will be remembered in French class for her tireless desire to communicate in the language that she is learning and the constant intellectual curiosity to know and appreciate more about other cultures. This year's recipient is Alexandra Parsons. To Latin. The recipient of the 4-year Latin award is a conscientious student whose work always reflects his desire to excel. He is a dependable student whose participation and accuracy set a great example in the class. His strengths as a student are complemented by his commendable behavior, by the respect he shows to others, and by his solid sense of humor, which have been especially beneficial during this difficult year and a transition to a new Latin teacher. Congratulations, Kang Dang, on all of your Spanish Award. As a ninth grader, the recipient of the four-year Spanish Award was already an outstanding student with incredible language talents. She has spent the entirety of her time at East Catholic impressing her peers and her teachers alike with her steadfast dedication to excellence. Her way of proceeding exceeds expectations as her gifts combine a tireless work ethic, great attention to detail, and a constant striving for more knowledge. Her tremendous efforts in all things, her depth, her humility, and her poise are known and admired by all in our department. Her excellence in communication in Spanish will continue beyond her days at East. She has already traveled to and encountered beautiful culture in Guatemala, and this year, in her AP class, she has presented us with updates on news from this country that is close to her heart. Keep sharing your knowledge of Spanish in our world, Ali. Congratulations on all of your accomplishments on behalf of our department. It's been an honor and blessing to be your teacher. Congratulations, Alexander Biden.
Thanks so much. Have a great evening.